everybody. I've got a question for you. Do you see these four objects over here? What do you think they have in common? Now, before you guess, let's go ahead and identify what they are. Here we've got an eastern box turtle shell. This is a skull. Here's a clam. And up here, up front, we have an ordinary chicken egg. Okay? These four objects have something in common. And let me give you a hint what it is. It has to do with their shape. So take a look at their shape, and what do you think? Pretty easy to guess, right? They all are curved. You notice there's roundness to every one of them. Now, this is a theme that you see in nature over and over again. It's like, why do so many things in nature have this curve? Well, oftentimes, it has to do with structural strength. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Let's say I want to build a bridge across here. Let's say I want to get from here all the way here. I don't have magical powers. I can't fly. And let's say I don't want to fall down because there's something horrible down there, like hot lava, okay? Or alligators. Or worse, alligators in the hot lava, okay? And I decide to build my bridge out of a thin sheet of paper. Why? I don't know. It was just my choice, all right? So it's a thin sheet of paper. That's my bridge. This little block represents me. So here I go. Uh-oh. Didn't make it. No surprise, though, right? You're looking at this and you're saying, well, of course, look how thin this is. What were you thinking, right? But let me show you something. This chicken eggshell, it is thin and it works just fine. This turtle shell's thin and your skull is relatively thin compared to other bones of your body, okay? So why is it that they're thin and they work? They work because of the magic of the curve. Actually, it's not magic, it's science. Check this out. Put a curve in this piece of paper. Now let's try to walk across. Here I go. Oh my goodness, look at that. It's fully supporting me. No problem. And all we did is, remember, it's the same sheet of paper. We just put a curve in it, and that's it. But if I try to put two people on there, what do you think is going to happen? Yeah, I'm not going to do that. It looks like it's going to collapse. And you would say, yeah, this piece of paper can hold approximately one person. But nature says, uh-uh, not so fast. Nature has other designs up its sleeve. Check this out. Let's say we pick up these at the beach, and you look and you say, yeah, we have two seashells, a cockle shell and a scallop. They're curved, just like our other objects. But in addition to the curve, you'll notice something else. Check this out. Do you see those ridges in there? Almost like a potato chip, right? And it makes it stronger. But how? Look at this. Watch what happens when I take a sheet of paper, fold it back and forth to make ridges. So here's one I already did. Place that across there. Now let's try. Here I go. Confidently walking across. No problem. How about a friend? Easy. How about more people? Three people. Four. Let's get crazy here. Five. Look at this. Six times the weight on that same sheet of paper. Amazing. Now remember, when it was flat, it held, well, it held exactly zero. When it was curved, it held one. And now with some simple ridges in it, look at this. It's holding six times the weight. Really amazing. Now, nature's been doing this sort of thing, using curves and ridges for millions and millions of years. Humans only for thousands. But think of things like the Roman aqueducts. They've been around for 2,000 years, some of them. And they've got that arch, that curve. Or an igloo. It's made out of snow. And yet, here it is. It's supporting itself, make a nice little structure for a family to live in. Now, something a little closer to home. Let's say that you are moving from one house to a new house, and your parents say, hey, it's time to pack up. What do you generally put everything in? We usually stuff everything in a cardboard box. And let me show you why. Let me show you what a cardboard box is. It's actually just three sheets of paper. Watch this. One sheet, two sheets, three sheets. But the middle sheet, that third sheet, is folded. Corrugated, right? You've heard of corrugated cardboard. Check this out. See that right there? Actually, you know what? We have a real specimen here to show you. A real cardboard box. Check it out. Let's see what we got here. One sheet of paper, two sheets of paper, and if you look very closely there, can you see the little ridges in there? Makes all the difference in the world. Now you've got a very sturdy box, okay? So let me tell you something. If you study nature, one thing is, you'll never be bored, but you might end up getting some great design ideas. So I hope this was interesting to you, and I hope that you guys have a great day. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye-bye.